Creamy, juicy, and fabulously fresh flavors are on the menu today here at Casa Daza. I can't wait to share with you my new favorite recipes featuring one of the best seafood available in the market today. I'm talking about top quality Norwegian Atlantic salmon. Boom!
Just recently, the Royal Norwegian Embassy came to us and said, "Hey, you know, we want to introduce to you our seafoods." "So what are they?" I asked. They told me, "Salmon." I jumped right away. Of course, I tried to look cool. "Bacalao." And king crab legs. You know, I was so excited. So I started researching, what can I make out of Norwegian Atlantic salmon? Ang dami pala. So here I'm going to show you how to make a variety of delicious salmon recipes that you can cook at home. You know, trust me, the quality of the salmon from Norway is absolutely unbelievable. Look at this. Tignan mo. Look at the color. You can tell from the color na lang eh. Look at that. My son and I, Turo, his favorite restaurant is this Japanese chain, ano? And they specialize in tonkatsu. What they do there is, because we have tonkatsu na pork, one time he ordered salmon tonkatsu. Oh my gosh, it was so good, it was so healthy. That's what I'm going to share with you. First recipe we're going to do today is salmon tonkatsu. Just wait, babalik ako.
You know what? Why stop at salmon belly when we have perfectly good salmon fillet here?
The restaurant I used to go to in Vancouver, it was called Chi Sushi. And they would have salmon belly. They would remove the skin, actually. Kala mo, tapo na yun. They dip that in teriyaki sauce and char it. And the skin was so good and healthy. Because this is good, this is good oil, no? You know, I lived in Vancouver for about 10 years, salmon. Every time I'd go to Chinatown, I remember, the salmon head was given for free until we Filipinos came along and started using it to make sinigang. They started charging 50 cents per kilo, which is not bad, di ba?
Here's a fun fact for you, my foodie friends. Did you know that the Japanese didn't really make sushi out of their native Pacific salmon? I heard that it was only when Norwegian Atlantic salmon was made available to Asia that they started offering what we now know and love as salmon sashimi. If that doesn't speak of the quality of these products, I don't know what will.
We're going to have three more other dishes called tom yum. You remember the Thai soup, yung Thai sinigang nila? Or actually, if you just want to make it yung Pinoy sinigang, which is the number one soup in the world today, you can do that also. But so may konting variety, everybody knows how to make sinigang. And I'm just going to show you how I make tom yum. Okay? Very local version. Okay? And then I'm going to make also a, di ba yung Singaporean dish that is very popular is seafood curry head. I'm going to make that. Okay, let's start doing this.
Get ready for a super crispy treat. Norwegian Atlantic Salmon Tonkatsu is up next here on Casa Daza. Welcome back to Casa Daza, Norway. No, I'm not in Scandinavia, but I have the next best thing right here in my kitchen today. A few slabs and cuts of incredibly fresh, blast-frozen Norwegian Atlantic salmon. For me, one of the most exciting things you can add to such a rich and buttery fish is some serious crunch. Flaky salmon is just perfect for English fish and chips. But today, I'm craving the texture of panko. So we're putting a bit of Japanese twist to this.
To all of you out there, guys, trust me. This is so, so simple to make. It is absolutely delicious and healthy. Okay? We are going to make a salmon tonkatsu with a tartar sauce. Very simple lang tartar sauce. But you use your imagination. You can add whatever ingredients you have.
Tonkatsu is such a simple dish, but it truly relies on good quality salmon. We will also need flour, salt and pepper, eggs, oil, and good old panko or Japanese breadcrumbs. Yes, it's that simple.
So we're gonna start off with a nice, beautiful, look at that, ganda. Okay, salmon fillet na yan. Make some, actually you can even make it smaller, no? Para talagang you maximize the crispiness of this delicious salmon. Mm. Okay, so yan na yung fillet natin. We have our flour, we have our eggs. Okay. We're going to make an assembly line of breading. So it's very important that you have oil, okay, in the eggs. Okay. This, I learned this, para it really sticks. Okay.
I suggest you place your flour, egg wash, and panko breading station right next to your heated pan. No one wants batter all over their kitchen, right? Right. Now on to the fun part.
So flour, you start off with flour. Coat each salmon with this. Actually, you can, this is your basic breading procedure already. Okay. And this you compress, or you can put some of the Japanese breadcrumbs, panko over, and then just drop. You have to make sure that your oil is very hot, so mga 350 degrees Fahrenheit, so that you shock it, so that it creates a crust outside. The outside is crispy and golden brown, while the inside is still moist. Okay, so it's very important na mainit ito. And get a good pan, because the good pan, what it does is, the heat is equally distributed, no? Let's make a few more. Do I have to season the flour? You can do that, but you know what? It really relies on the sauce, yung tartar sauce natin. Or you can even get the bulldog sauce. Yung bulldog sauce, you can make yourself, no? But better if you can just buy it in the mga Korean store or to the Japanese store. So, nice to do this as a student, itong egg wash na to. So, medyo I can do this with my eyes closed all up. Look at this. Look at this. It's very important also, after you fry this, for about, at the most, siguro mga minute and a half, 2 minutes, you make sure you don't over-fry it, because the moment you lift it up, it's still continuing to cook.
Nothing to it, right? Boom!
Look. That's done. Now, when I lift it up like this, okay, you lift it up, it looks a little bit pale, but as you give it a little more air, it's gonna turn dark brown. Ayun, mainit. Okay, yan. Look at that. Look at that. Nice. Ganda. You know, you will love this, and it's a new discovery as long as you get, of course, very good quality salmon. Yan. Okay, make sure that you give it space to breathe. Now, we are going to assemble our tartar sauce. Actually, it's very easy.
All you need to do is put together loads of sweet and sour flavors, a good amount of zing, and a dash of spice. Easy peasy.
I have some mayonnaise. Who doesn't like mayonnaise? Pickle relish. Yum. Use your imagination. You want to put a little mustard? Why not? Then red onion, so that's a little bit stronger. Okay, a little lemon juice. Ako, I would add chopped hard-boiled eggs. Uy, diba? Then a little pepper. Yum. Then, mix. Ganyan lang. Okay, that's it. Now, let us taste it. Mmm. Stop it. Sarap. Okay siya.
Ta-da! Crispy, juicy, flaky salmon tonkatsu served with the tangy flavors of our homemade tartar sauce.
Okay, I don't know if you noticed this, but I've arranged it in such a way that the crispy tonkatsu salmon can breathe so that it doesn't lose its crispiness. Now, it's tasting time. So let's get one. Okay, let me get some of this delicious sauce tartar, homemade sauce tartar. Look at that. Look how beautifully perfect that is. So it's still moist, very crunchy outside. I don't know if you can hear that crunch, but it's so good. Look at it. It's crunchy outside and very moist inside. Perfect combination. Sarap. My gosh.
If you have kids around, you need to make sure you make enough because I promise you, this will disappear F-A-S-T.
Norwegian Atlantic Salmon Fillet. Yummy!
Thai and Japanese flavors give delicious new dimensions to the star of today's episode. A double serving of your favorite fish is up ahead when Casa Daza returns.
Doing recipes making use of Norwegian Atlantic salmon. Anyway, I'm going to make two recipes. One is going to be tom yum. We had a Thai restaurant before. We had three Thai chefs and I'd watch them make tom yum. It's actually their version of our sinigang. It's very good. Actually, you can even use a recipe of sinigang using this high-grade quality salmon. Now, I'm going to use the different cuts of salmon, yung belly and the head and some of the fillet.
To add a vibrant Thai twist to these delicious cuts, we are making use of the following bright flavors: lemongrass, langquas, red and white onions, some chili garlic paste, patis, siling haba, spring onions, calamansi, chili oil, water, and kangkong. They may look like a lot of ingredients, but trust me, cooking tom yum cannot be simpler.
Okay, so let me start. I have here some water. It's just a matter of adding all the ingredients together. No? I'll put in our white and red onions. Okay. Look at that. So I have here some calamansi. Wow, this is nice and soft. You remember the characteristic of a Thai dish. It has saltiness, it has sourness, there's a little bit sweetness except for this one, and then spice. And then I have some chili garlic. Look at this. From the ingredients alone, mapapaano kayong ganun, no? And then we have some siling haba or jalapeno sili. Okay. Langquas. Now, if you don't have langquas, this is like Chinese ginger, no? You can get this also sometimes in the palengke. But if you don't have this, don't make it a problem. You can just exaggerate your lemongrass. And then we have some spring onions. Okay. Yes, we get our lemongrass also, okay? Yeah. Now, at this point, okay, this is still a little bit bland because the flavors are not out yet. And the vegetables have, they don't have naman seasoning, but they have their own flavors, no? So we let this simmer for a while. Okay. Let me taste it. I want to see, you know, the building of the ingredients here. Okay, there's none. All I can taste is the spiciness. What we will do is add some patis.
While our tom yum simmers away, how about use the rest of the salmon for another dish? Yes? Yes!
Now I'm going to shift to another recipe called Norwegian Atlantic Salmon Belly. Sarap ito. Teriyaki ito, ha? Teriyaki.
Have you heard of the term Japandi? It's a mix of Japanese and Scandinavian aesthetics that's been taking the home design world by storm. Let me try and do a food version of that by combining some quality salmon belly with a basic teriyaki marinade of water, brown sugar, soy sauce, garlic, honey, sesame oil, and ginger. Boom!
You know, if you find that the sauce is not thick enough, what you can do is you can add a slurry, which is a mixture of cornstarch and water. But as it is, okay na to. Uy, okay. You know, there are different kinds of teriyaki eh. There's yung very simple soy sauce and sugar, pwede ng teriyaki. But this one is the Japanese style, which has ginger. That's one thing I noticed about it. Okay, so let's set this aside. I suggest you get a beautiful grill pan like this one. This is where we'll grill our Norwegian salmon belly. Look at the quality of this one. It's so beautiful. Look at that. Ganda.
Before we move forward with the salmon belly teriyaki, let's check in on our tom yum.
Ayan na, nabubuhay na siya eh. There's spice, there's saltiness, kulang pa ng patis. I'm gonna add the patis. This is delicious! Woo! Patay! Patay, 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 patay.
Out with the lemongrass. And our soup is ready for some serious salmon. Meanwhile, the salmon head and bones have started to flavor our soup.
We're at this point already. What I'll do naman is I have a grill. I'll put a little oil. Okay. I have some salmon belly. And yung salmon belly is ready. Kaya ganda oh. I don't want to overcook it like I mentioned, diba? But because of the yung fillet being a little more thick, that will take a little while longer to cook. But look at this, oh. There is a little crunch from the sugar and softness from the moist meat. Remember the salmon fillet that I have? Now it's ready to be dropped. Okay. Wow, this is okay nito. This is good. Now, it's nice, it's sour, it's salty, it's spicy, and then we add a little chili oil. Ito na ba yung chili oil ko? Ito. Ito yun eh, last finishing touches na itong chili oil. And then we add some kapun.
Juggling these two dishes on the stove at once is not really that hard. You just need to keep an eye on the salmon on the grill, which takes so much less time to cook than the tom yum.
Yan, this one is done. Alam mo, you have to be careful also because the sugars will cause it to burn. But look at this, oh. Look at this. Look how beautiful those are.
If you want to take the salmon teriyaki bites to the next level, you can make some teriyaki sauce from your marinade.
To strain the teriyaki sauce, heat it a little bit, siguro about a minute lang, and then use this as a dipping sauce for that. It's delicious. Yan na, the kangkong is almost done. I can't wait to try this. Actually, if I turn it off at this point, the heat, it's still going to continue to cook. Let me taste it. So, the flavors of the kangkong, the langkwas, the onions, the chili, all combined with the fresh Norwegian salmon. Whoa, okay na. Good.
The only thing more impressive than these two incredible dishes is the fact that you can cook both of them in under 30 minutes. Boom!
Norwegian Atlantic Salmon Tom Yum. We have different cuts here. I have the belly or the head or the fillet. But what I will start off with is the head. Wow. Mmm. Spires, sourness, saltiness. This is so good. Sarap. Very, very nice. Now, teriyaki naman. Mmm. You know, there's a little burnt. Not burnt, but there's a crust from the sugar, and it is so good. You know, sometimes when you're frying this on a yung grill pan, you will see the smoke. Eh. Don't wait for the smoke to turn dark because it's burned already when it's like that. So there's a little smoke. It's burning the sugar, but this is so good. Ang sarap with yung leeks or spring onions.
These two dishes will make salmon lovers out of anyone. Trust me.
Winner. Boom ito, boom.
Up next, I'll show you a simple recipe for a filling salmon head curry. See you when Casa Daza comes back. When it comes to comfort food, few things can compare to a good curry. It's warm, it's rich, and it's healthy. Plus, it is really very easy to make too. But if you want to level up your curry dishes, you should definitely try it using this grade A ingredient.
Norwegian Atlantic Salmon. You know what? It's very important to know the source of your products, okay? Now, this one comes from Norway. What they do is they catch it fresh, it's still alive, they blast freeze it, and then they send it to Manila. When they send it to Manila, this is something that you can get in Santis, okay? Now, I'll show you what features to look out for. Look at the ice, see? Yeah, that's freshness, look at the color, okay?
Some of the things you should look out for are clear eyes, firm flesh that bounces back when you press lightly on it, and a bright orange-red color.
What I'm going to do today is a very popular dish. I love this every time I go to Singapore. This one is called fish head curry. Okay, now, the key here is to get a good, fresh, and delicious salmon. And yes, okay, you can have the fillet. That's okay. But me personally, I like to go to the corners like the head, the belly, this yung the middle part. So make use of that. As Filipinos naman, we eat all the parts, di ba?
The rest of our ingredients include oil, garlic, white onions, curry powder, water, a shrimp or chicken cube, gata, potatoes, silinghaba, patis, and hard-boiled eggs.
Let's start sauteing some garlic. Now, we're not going to brown the garlic. We're just going to extract and shrink the flavor in our onions. And the signs that you look at are the yung opaque or the onions turning parang see-through. And what we will do is we'll add in our water. We'll add in our curry powder. You know what? I'll tell you something about my recipes. All my recipes, I personally taste them. I test them. Sometimes they don't work out. Then I adjust until I can come up with a product that I'm happy with and comfortable enough to share with you. Because in the end, if hindi masarap, you'll say, Tandy, nabola tayo. That's very important really to me. And then, we will add in our gata. Okay. Yung potatoes, you have to soak this in water because there's oxidation that occurs right away and it's gonna turn brown. Okay, so you have to be very careful with this. this point, what we want to do is just mix it well. Now, we are going to wait until the potatoes are done before we season this. And the seasoning is just going to be patis, okay? You know what? There's a little flavor in the coconut milk and the chicken cube. Okay, now, I'm gonna put patis. Okay. Okay na siya. Okay na, it's perfect. So that's about a tablespoon and a half of patis. I'm going to get some siling haba. Slice it lang. I'm not gonna remove the seeds. You know why? The seeds will make it spicy. But the coconut milk will neutralize it. So at this point, okay, we've added everything. Slowly lang. The indicator is the moment the potatoes are done, we can add the hard-boiled eggs and the salmon last. Okay? Let's come back to this one. Okay, tasting. You know, the taste is perfect, the seasoning is perfect, but I can taste what's slowly developing is the added spice from the, ano, yung sili. Ang sarap niya. Woo! Lagay natin tong ano. Let's put in our hard-cooked eggs. You know, curry and hard-cooked eggs, they work so well together. Diba? Yan na.
Since the head cooks longest, I'll add that into the curry a full 5 minutes before the other bony salmon pieces.
You know, I was so happy when Anna from the Royal Norwegian Embassy got in touch with me kasi parang, oh my gosh, this is such a dream come true for me because I love creating recipes with outstanding quality ingredients, di ba?
After simmering covered for around 5 minutes, our salmon fillet can be finally added to our curry.
So what we will do is we'll cover this, maybe about 10 minutes, turn off the heat and leave it as is. And trust me, this is so simple yet this is so delicious. The problem is, you're gonna eat a lot of rice with this, that I promise you.
Isn't she a beauty? Trust me, this is the most luxurious tasting salmon head curry you can make in just 30 minutes. Without further ado, it's tasting time.
Fresh salmon. Mmm. So good. You know it's a little bit spicy from the chili, and then it's nice and perfectly cooked.
Now, wasn't that easy to make? In fact, all the recipes we did today were designed to be remarkably easy to follow, so you have every reason to try them out yourself.
I showed you how simple it is to make each one. You know what's key also? Is the source of your ingredients. Norwegian Atlantic Salmon. You'll find this at Santis. You can request. You want the head, you want the belly, you want the fillet. Very, very important. You have to make sure you have to get the best source of fresh salmon.